toll booth to get out to Sanibel. Panarasa in the distance here. It's hard to imagine that the only way on and off Sanibel and Captiva is cut off. The Sanibel Causeway has been here 30 years and it's weathered many, many storms and hurricanes, and this has never happened. It's impressive to see. I mean, they've already got cranes out here. They've got trucks, heavy equipment, already doing what they can to try to open up some kind of road between Sanibel and the mainland. We understand that the plans, emergency plans, have already been pretty much put together. The state came down to help Lee County do that. They're going to get the designs together as quickly as possible. That's what they're doing right now, and put this out for bid and get the workers in here as soon as possible. But you can see where the island, just the man-made islands, just washed away. And the Sanibel Causeway was breached in 5 different places. So not only did the man-made islands wash away, but the road and the bridge itself in 5 different places. And what I didn't realize was all of the islands are breached, not just one. So there's 5 different areas where the causeway crumbled. This is the last span before you get onto Sanibel Island, and it looks intact. Now we're approaching Sanibel Lighthouse Condos. There's already a heavy barge out here. That's a good sign. You see a big piece of equipment is already out here, hopefully getting started on the work. So if you head to Periwinkle, and if you want to make a left to go over the canal system to get to the southern, or actually they call it the eastern end of Sanibel, the bridge is gone. You see the bridge? So not only is Sanibel cut off from the mainland, but within the island, a lot of the bridges have been washed away as well. Can we fly near the lighthouse? Yeah, go take a look at the lighthouse. We had heard rumors during the storm that the lighthouse had washed away, but there it is, it's still there. It's missing one leg, and the structure next to it, the little house next to it, is gone now. But the iconic Sanibel Lighthouse made it through the storm. It's a little bit of a beacon of hope for this beautiful island. A lot of the homes on this end of the island seem to have withstood the brunt of the storm. Sure, there's some roofs missing, pool cages torn, but for the most part, it's a different kind of destruction than you saw in Fort Myers Beach. Much different. These are the lighthouse condominiums. And there it is. A little to your... Yep, there's the Sanibel Lighthouse. It is super close to the beach, though. Man. Another storm could just wash that away, but you can see the building that used to be next to it is gone, but there it is. It's amazing how brown the island is with such a green, lush landscaping, and now it's just all brown. This is the parking lot. If you go out to Sanibel Island and you go left on Periwinkle and you park your car, that's where the parking lot used to be. And this is the beautiful white beaches of Sanibel, but look at the color of the water. I've never seen it so brown, even in the height of the algae blooms. It's never been this color. So we are on the eastern end. We just left the lighthouse and we're headed to the western end, or if you think of Sanibel north-south, we're headed north. Yeah, some of these inns and hotels are definitely going to have to rebuild. I believe that is the Holiday Inn on Fort Myers Beach. Pretty much part of it is just washed away over on the other side of the road. We're on West Gulf Boulevard. Sanibel definitely looks different than Fort Myers Beach. There's more buildings standing, a lot of roof damage. So you got to imagine the water that is inside all of those condominiums. And if it's months before you can get any heavy equipment out here to make repairs, the mold and the rebuilding is almost too much to even think about. So, okay, here we are coming up on the Holiday Inn. Yeah, the surge came up so high that it just pretty much washed out all the beaches and created like little divots in each one all along the shore. This is the Sundial Resort. And beyond that, the Dunes Golf Course. We're still over the Sundial Resort. A lot of damage there, especially to the beachfront units. The farther inland you go on the island, from what we can see, it looks like a little bit less damage. Some of the newer structures held up better. Again, we are headed up Middle Gulf Drive. This is Cassie Bell Resort right here. That's where I got married. The next, that way. Yep, that's, yep. It's Cassie Bell Resort. And the restaurant there, and that's where, that took a hard hit. Beautiful, beautiful. Beachfront, lush green. Got married there almost 20 years ago. Restaurant is a favorite of a lot of people's, gorgeous, and that took a big hit. Sad to see. We're going to come back out here for our 20th. This is the Cassie Bell Resort. It looks like a lot of damage. The roof is gone for most of the structure. Yeah, it's not sand. I mean, it's hard to imagine what is in the street right now. I can't even describe the color of it and the thickness of it. Yeah. It's a muck, a thick sludge that's just covering the streets of Sanibel. The lush green. Sanibel is known for its, there's roofs just off of houses here. We're getting a lot more destruction as we head up Middle Gulf Drive. And it's just gone. Yep. Yeah. I think there's just roofs everywhere. So we're coming up on Algiers Beach on Sanibel. This is Hussey Bell Road here that you're looking at in Middle Gulf Drive. We just passed the Sanibel Island Golf Club. Gulfside City Beach Park. And you can just see all the roofs. Looks like this is the Shalimar Cottages and Motel. I think it used to be the Hurricane House Resort, Waterside Inn, Island Inn on West Gulf Drive. So this is West Gulf Drive, and all the little beachside inns that families have been coming to for years. And that's what makes Sanibel so unique and so beautiful, is that 25% of the island is dedicated to open space and greenery. And now there's nothing green on the island anymore. We're heading up now towards Rabbit Road. The West Wind Island Resort, the Island Inn, all of this along here, you can see. Yep. I believe this is the West Wind Island Resort. It's just gone. And we're just approaching Rabbit Road right now, but the Island Inn, West Wind Inn, and there's Rabbit Road that cuts back over to Sanibel Captiva Road. So we're heading to some of the homes now on West Gulf Drive. The beachfront homes, and it's hit or miss. Some look like they're intact, and other homes are either washed away, destroyed, or they're missing a roof, or the damage is just unbelievable, even to tell from up here. So again, we're heading up West Gulf Drive, looking at the destruction on Sanibel Island. So many roofs. And you think about the force of the wind and the rain that poured into these homes, and it's going to be months before they can begin any repairs. because the infrastructure just isn't there. They have to clear out all these roads where you can find roads, and then they have to try to get heavy equipment out here. Just, it's such a monumental task. All right, we're still heading up towards Captiva, but we're right off of West Gulf Drive right now, looking at neighborhoods. This is not really a touristy. You can see, look at the two houses gone, right next to each other. So you can't imagine what the winds were in that area. These homes are on West Gulf. And they're gone. All right, now we're heading towards Captiva. These are the neighborhoods you see if you're driving out to Captiva, and they're on, you can see the entrances on the left-hand side. Can't really ever see the homes from the road. But like Rue, Belmare, Tahiti Drive, Jamaica Drive, that's all what you're seeing in here. And the damage is pretty extensive. Can you zoom in to some of these homes along here? Along the beach? Yeah. Yes, it's not as bad. It's a different story. That's the Tropical Winds Motel and Cottages. Everything is so brown. The water is so brown. It's just really sad. Okay, you can see Sanibel Captiva Road in the distance there, the water tower, and then we're headed towards what they call Santiva, the little island, not really an island, but the little community in between Sanibel and Captiva. If you look straight ahead, you can see the Sunset Grill. And the area where Sanibel just shored up that road right there because it was washing away in some storms. So they spent millions of dollars to kind of reinforce Sanibel Captiva Road. And that held up pretty well. But if you can go over towards those pink buildings and kind of zoom in there, that is the Sunset Grill. The Lazy Flamingo is that pink building right there. And this is kind of where, when you get to, right before you cross over onto Sanibel Island, the Castaway Cottages are right, well, they used to be right there. A lot of them have washed away onto the other side of the road. And you can just see, the roof has just collapsed on the Sunset Grill and the little market there. The iconic cottages that people like to rent, they've been washed away. And then this is the bridge to get onto Captiva. And you can see there's an army vehicle, it looks like, there, staged on the bridge to Captiva, I'm sure to make sure that nobody goes underneath the pass. That's Turner Beach Park and Blind Pass right there. So Blind Pass was kind of shut a little bit, had been filling in with sand, and now it's wide open. Turner Beach is where a lot of people, if you're coming out here, you could find parking. And now we're headed up Captiva Drive. This is a look at all the homes on Captiva Drive. A lot of them have names at the end of the road. It's fun if you're driving out here to get a look at them. A lot of these are newer structures, so they seem to have they stood up pretty good against this storm. Beautiful Captiva Beach. People come from around the world to vacation here or to drive out here for the day and enjoy this wonderful little tiny island community. Yes. Yes, they were. Most of them have been built after. And it's kind of been a we're coming up on Tween Waters Resort here. And Tween Waters has done a lot of renovations lately. And the newer buildings, they're okay. Coast Guard, you can see they're... Okay, let's go back to, so you can see somebody's driving on the beach. Looks like some kind of official government personnel driving. This is the curve here when you get past Tween Waters and you head into Captiva Village. So they made it out this far, emergency personnel. There's the Green Flash restaurant. You see what that is, Sebastian? So this is the bayside of Captiva Island. A lot of roof damage, but definitely a much different picture than on Fort Myers Beach, where there's total devastation. A lot of structures are standing. So let's follow that personnel because they're coming up on the four-way stop of Andy Rossi Lane there. In the bubble room, you see just to the top of your screen, you can see the pink building, the colorful building. The bubble room is kind of a tradition. Some place you definitely have to take family. They're known for their cakes and desserts. Andy Rossi Lane, we have to, looks like the fire station there is where people are staging, and it looks like it fared pretty well. If we could go out towards the beach a little bit more at the end of Andy Rossi Lane, you can see a lot of people asking us if the Mucky Duck survived. It's kind of the place you like to go for sunset. So if we, the bayside, so if we point the camera back out towards the beach, and I can't even tell if the Mucky Duck is still there. So let's pan over to your right, and you can see Andy Rossi Lane with those orange-colored roofs. Yep, that's Andy Rossi Lane. So a lot of those houses survived, and if you go to the end of it towards the beach, it's the Mucky Duck, and it's still standing, but it's got a lot of damage, a lot of roof damage. Looks like the beach pretty much washed up into the Mucky Duck. One of the few places in town, restaurants to go to where you can watch the sunset. Sanibel's known for its sunsets and its shells, Sanibel and Captiva. Geez, you know, it fared pretty well. The issue is just going to be all the mold and water inside a lot of these homes that, you know, there won't be power on here for months, so there's going to be a lot of damage. You see YOLO there with all of their golf carts that they rent. And now we're looking at South Seas Resort, recently purchased by a new company. And they were making a lot of renovations here. And I think they're going to have to make a lot more. This is the South Seas Resort on the very northern tip of Captiva Island. Great place for a staycation. And you see a lot of roof damage here, but the buildings are still standing. So it was a much different story after Hurricane Charley. South Seas was pretty much flattened during Hurricane Charley. And it's a different story now. A lot of the buildings are still standing at South Seas. So that's good to see. Their roads are passable into South Seas. And you can see they're already starting. There's cars out here now. Not people, but official cars, probably still assessing the damage. We're heading north now from South Seas Resort, which ends at Redfish Pass, and then you get into North Captiva. And you think about the history of hurricanes here in some ways, because this is where, this is Redfish Pass, right here coming up on as we leave South Seas Resort. Do you have, let's go a little bit north to Cayo Costa. Okay, I can point you. Nope, it's one island. This is Pine Island Sound right here. And Hurricane Charley came through here and cut North Captiva pretty much in half. It eventually filled in just recently, but, and it didn't split again, but man, there's nothing green left. North Captiva fared pretty well, so I think we can just head into Pine Island if you'd like.